And I'm gonna share with you guys some top tips to succeed. These are things that I figured out. So if anybody knows my story, you know I started building my business in 2010. I did it on my girlfriend's red IKEA couch. I've shared the photo, the embarrassing photo of doing this on my girlfriend's red IKEA couch. The most amazing thing in the story is we ended up getting married. So she saw something in me, I guess. So anyways, let's get right into it. Let's dive into some tips. So what are some things we can do to take advantage of, you know, all of the opportunities from a transaction count perspective? Because the total number of transactions should drastically be going up in the real estate space over the next 12 to 18 months. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. I'm not saying we ain't going to have short sales and foreclosures. I'm just saying, like, we're going to have a lot more transactions happening in the residential real estate market. So tip number one that I want to encourage everybody to think about is investing in scalable lead generation strategies. Scalable lead generation strategies. I'm going to say something that is probably very polarizing, especially if you've been through like Brian Buffini training, but it is very, very difficult to build a business. A business is something that like you don't have to be in every single day. A business can operate without you. There's a difference between owning a job and owning a business. So for those of you guys that are building a team, a brokerage, like if you want to own a business, you need to find scalable lead generation strategies. And being referral based is not a scalable and predictable lead generation strategy. It's not scalable and predictable. In fact, unless you're going to go down this path of building a brokerage that is predicated on having a bunch of agents, your value proposition is not actually to help agents generate a lot of referrals, right? So like the big box brokerages, like they should be telling their agents like, hey, go get referrals, work your database, do all these things, because that keeps their agents on the hamster wheel of doing deals. Because if you're referral based, it means you're always going to be working in the business and not on the business. So a lot of the messaging, if you think about what the big box brokerages push, it's to keep you on that hamster wheel. So if, again, if you're on this call and you're interested in building a business versus owning a job, the thing I want you to think about to scale and to take advantage of the increase in transaction count is think about scalable lead generation strategies. So these are things where basically like you allocate a budget, you turn it on, and it generates leads for you consistently at a very high conversion rate. That's the second component to this tip that's going to be very, very important for people to track. And this is super, super important. Pay attention to your client acquisition cost. So something that's happening from a marketing perspective right now is where people spend time, it's changing. So for example, I don't know if you guys have driven down the highway, but there's not nearly as many cars going down the highway. So when you think about marketing, it's you're ultimately buying impressions. And so if you guys have ever built a Facebook ad, for example, you go in and you pay per impression, right? It's like a penny per impression, right? And a certain number of impressions equal a lead. Well, that kind of like, you know, non-scientific thing is also holds true to things like billboards, right? Like if you're running billboards and you're paying $10,000 a month, but for example, now there's 50% less traffic, you know, your cost per thousand went really high, a lot less people saw your billboard, you're gonna get less calls, right? So you can't keep spending, for example, $10,000 on a billboard. Like you've gotta get your cost down to take into account that there's a lot less people driving down the highway. So when you're thinking about client acquisition cost, your cost per thousand, it's called CPM in marketing. That's one of the like the number one leading indicators to be tracking. So that, you know, when you notice like your cost per thousand, like skyrocket or whatever, like that's an early indicator that your client acquisition cost, which you don't know what your client acquisition cost is going to be until the deal closes. And you're like, oh yeah, that lead came from Zillow or that lead came from direct mail. Right? You don't know until the end. So cost per thousand and cost per lead, those are your early indicators of success. So these are really the two biggest things I can encourage you to focus on from a marketing perspective, going into the end of 2020 and going into 2021, if you're trying to build a business, not own a job. Like if you guys, I'm not saying one way is right or the other. Like I'm not saying like building out a big team and brokerage is like the right way. I'm not saying like going and crushing it as an agent is the right or wrong way. Like, you know, I'm just saying like specifically for those of you guys wanting to build a brokerage and team, like that's got a lead generation component to it. Like this is what you need to focus on. Now, if you guys are on this call and you're a solo agent and you want to keep crushing it as a solo agent, then yes, double down on referrals and keep doing that. But for those of you guys trying to build a business, this is my number one tip to you going into 2021.